Commented for family viewing.
It is another fine morning down here in Kampala. Debt check, it is 12th of February 2020. A very good morning and thank you very much for joining us on yet another fresh episode of Urban Today right here on Urban Television. It's going to be another 2 hours of nothing but infotainment, so be sure to buckle it up because you definitely don't want to miss out on any single bit. Today on the show, we'll be still talking about the locust invasion, looking at a couple of reports coming in from as far as this fight is concerned. Also, interestingly, the government comes out to say that they do need 7 billion Ugandan shillings extra in the fight of the locust invasion. Away from that, we'll take you all the way to China, whereby we have the death toll number increasing to over 1,000 as far as the coronavirus is concerned. And later on, we'll be talking about the Harvest Man Expo. We'll be having guests joining us in studio, so it's definitely going to be an interesting show. And on the top of the hour, at exactly 10 a.m., we'll flip the script and talk love relationships. This letter could be actually something that is happening to you, so you need to keep it live with us. Remember that we are as well live on social media. Facebook, it is Urban Television, and Twitter, it is at Urban TV Uganda. My name is Derek Ainedasha, and me and Willis Daly will be holding it down. We're doing it the men's way. The women are away, right? All the women have disappeared. I don't know.
We decided to have a men's conference.
For us, it has started here. Good morning to you, Delia.
Good morning. And so those of you that thought the locusts are only in Africa, the locusts are actually now in Pakistan as we speak.
So from Uganda, their next destination was Pakistan. What is happening?
So those of us who eat Pakistan rice, we might be in for a shock.
Imagine opening your pack of, you know, Pakistan rice. You reach home, you're going to prepare for bear, some kamere. You open and then a locust falls out. What do you do? Do you eat the locust as well, or?
Well, being Ugandan, you fry it and eat it, but. Meanwhile, government went to the districts of Katakwi and they're still looking for locusts. So I don't know what's up.
What's happening?
They said the locusts were there. Uh-huh. I think the pictures we see in the media, in the, you know, presses and whatnot, those pictures are not
the internet pictures. So yeah, are you saying that there are no locusts in Katakwi?
Well, they are there, but I think they are hatching right now. That's why people are not seeing them as, you know, we thought we would see them.
Okay.
So I think they are hatching.
So they are multiplying.
Now. Yes.
So we could be in for a shock.
Yeah, we could be in for a shock. As soon as they finish hatching, then disaster will just rain on us.
Is that why government is asking for extra 7 billion?
I saw a video of someone in Kenya. It was an army guy who was blowing a whistle.
I thought he was actually in Uganda.
No, he was in Kenya. Yeah. And they were chasing away the locusts. So are you telling me the 7 billion are going to buy whistles or what?
Yeah, they're going to buy whistles and whistleblowers.
Just give me the job, man.
You can blow.
Give me the job. Get Balaam, put his speakers there, and get just one car guy to blow and amplify the sound.
Actually, that would work. I don't know why we are wasting money. Mm. If it worked in Kenya with the soldier, then it can definitely work here.
Yeah, you just get Balaam, Keti, they put equipment, put one car guy
in the entire Katakwi.
In the entire Katakwi, and just blow. Or if that's too much and you don't want to spend money buying whistles, put the speakers there, get Chameleon.
Why Chameleon?
Yeah, since all Ghana, Uganda. Anyam singer.
Fresh kid.
Owa Pastor Bujingo.
Mbonye. Bategeyo mbonye.
Mbonye tawo gana.
Akulatia.
Mbonye ayogera. Ayogera nechisa.
Mbonye kwa teka tolu kwa mbawa mteke.
Na atama yu zungu. Iji. Ajalu wana nechigambo chimu.
Loka siziba nyolu zungu. Obazo zi agala kelele bukelele.
Ndoziperi ngulu. Siziba nyolu
zungu. Oloza. Katolu kwa mbawa if he is to, you know, be put in those kind of shoes. Oloza chintu na yandichukua saganizati.
Well, Katolu Mama is a very intelligent guy. He's very, very intelligent. He's very, very intelligent. So, sima ite ya andikoze.
Ye kubia bukubia mizimu.
Katolu Mama ye kubia mizimu wanunga, you know. Uboya gala ka video katambulo, of course, ngola abantu iwa singo kwa gala. So, Katolu Mama just gives you what you want to hear, not what you want to listen. But deep down, he's intelligent.
Alright.
Ila na yachi mani.
Okay, we are starting off the show and would like to, you know, give you some highlights coming in from Kataki District as far as, you know, the fight for this locust is concerned. We do have a video edited and produced by our sister station, Bokede TV.
Government kakasizante minja bisatu ebienzige vya ingide kalamoja witu se mobitundu ebitesu na dalika takwe. Zino zaingi ya industry ya nolako ulegula chwa liza minisi wa blimio kusuru kila mom minisi wa blimio obulunzi nobu vise ni bambalanga sisi jam saa kumbezwe ya gulibajire ne minisi wa mizo teknoloji ya pito guanga bagenzi nga batu kide monyonyi Zinzida kuminisa sempi jenzi kiziba mudisi ya mokuda mudala. Nienga na mwote batude, mbali mkuzilo ndola.
This is Katakwi.
Yes.
Now it could be this one which was in Amudat. So we still have to confirm whether this is the same swamp and we are counting it twice or not.
Sempi jate kizani kamende, tibuli ndale naba kukubayo. Okulaba nga zikizino, zile nyebwa kumfete.
We have... three swarms now confirmed. We are surveying them. We are doing our surveillance and we have all the information now. We have the experts.
Adegezanti dagali litagi sam kuzifoyira. We didn't really know chukula kumacha.
Of course, you know, we don't spread during the day when it is warm. It must be very early at 5.
Ye minister bajira wajagida mutuzo butagoba nzige zino chokabo kirina bakwatibwa ko zirwanyisibwe
just tell us then we come because these yellow ones are not going to eat your what your crops
ah tegezanda chirunye zige zino ezimu lanje yache mvusiza bulabe nyo kubazi bazikuze
these so long as they are yellow those ones you know they have one job to lay eggs to further their generation they don't have any effect on man, on human beings, directly.
So we can eat them?
You can eat. Right now, before we start our exercise, you can. But they are not like Ensenene, as a scientist. Ensenene is soft. These ones are hard. So if you eat 50 Ensenenes, these ones you may not eat 50 because your stomach may have issues.
I think it's a good thing. I'm going to eat it. I'm going to eat it.
Those hoppers, are reddish brown and they are very destructive. Those are the ones that eat, they just, those ones eat anything green, they will even eat these vines. They are deadly. Now those ones are the ones that we are going to target. Those ones we are going to target because one of these lays up to about 300 eggs.
Ye minister gwanga tegizande embera bina ye abasubira kuzirinya kumfete.
So all we want is the spraying should begin with immediate effect so that we can arrest the spread.
Yes, it will gumble palamo. Emi or Girot agreed as good as that was Usaku Binuza Kawungese.
Most of those trees were all green, but where you see all they have eaten them.
Yes, so they are still free.
Oruna kuleta kamindu lege no kutanguzi fuiranga kwe sebi nitebe nja ulokuli. Nobu nye nyobu vuga mbuite drone ze. Wilfred Masaba. Ya kusaki degulie nukulao kede TV.
Nzige. But you see, what's interesting though is that when you see the people approaching the nzige, the nzige start to run away. So clearly, there are other simpler methods of dealing with nzige.
Mm-hmm.
And if I was a conservationist, I'll probably be against spraying them to death.
Why?
Because these
the
are
pesticides
part,
have nothing,
these are part
have
of
nothing
the
to affect on the plants.
The nzige are part of the ecosystem.
Mm.
And we need to research more about the effect of killing them. You see, the problem we have is we are reactionary. When they come to eat our food, we kill them.
Mm.
But what if we kill them, we are creating a you know, a deeper situation?
I want to believe there has been research that has been, you know, put into this.
I don't think so. When the nzige came, Minister of Agriculture automatically, Minister of Agriculture, Minister of Disaster Preparedness, of course there were meetings here and there, the Prime Minister.
The Prime Minister,
and
yes.
The whole consensus, even before research, was let's spray them to death. That's what, that was a consensus.
Mm-hmm, mm.
But what if spraying them to death is creating another problem?
Then we shall deal with it.
So shall we be reactionary? Will the chain go on, and where shall we? Shall it end?
I believe it's a step for us to learn from
you understand.
This particular
and
one. In
this
case that happens.
This spraying might be killing the nzige, but not the eggs. You understand? So what if we try the methods that, you know, other methods, maybe the noise method or so, or swing them into another direction and see how it goes.
Anyway,
because you can't kill them, you can't kill all the nzige that will come.
I want to refer to, you know, some words coming in from the Prime Minister recently when he had all these people coming through. He said there was research that was being done and they have finalized on what pesticide to use, because there are a variety of pesticides, but different pesticides have different effects, like you just mentioned. So I want to believe and be very optimistic that the pesticide they decided to use for this particular one is the one that will, you know,
there is no way
and
you
there shouldn't
convince,
be any side
there
effects.
Is no way you can convince me that you're spraying something on the plant and it has no effect on the plant.
I mean, we spray every day, every
even
now
you,
and day.
Even you, when you swallow medicine, it
of
kills,
course
it kills the diseases, but there are side effects on the human being.
That's very true, there are side effects. But what I'm trying to say is that we have been, you know, spraying over and over. We have, you know, the pesticides for the tomatoes. We have pesticides for, you know, different vegetables within the garden. And we understand there's a reason why they recommend those pesticides. There are no side effects.
There are side
on
effects.
The plants
there are
the
side
soil.
Effects because if you spray pesticides in a garden, chances are you might have to use fertilizers.
Actually, what I would be worried
forever.
About would be, you know, the pH quality of the soil. You know, what is going to be remaining after, you know, this pesticide has been, you know,
well, all those things, you know, need to be tabled. But for me, I think that, you know, we needed an intervention, and it's good that government is coming in to intervene, and it's good that, you know, some farms and gardens are going to be saved and people are going to have something to eat. But we need to put in more research, and we need to put it in fast. And there are other methods we can use to chase away the nzige. You know, if you see the ministers walking towards the nzige, you see the nzige moving. So clearly, sound movement scares away the nzige. Isn't that a better way to chase away the nzige? Can't government invest that 7 billion shillings they're asking for to put sounds and whatnot? I remember when we were chasing away monkeys when we were kids. And we were using scarecrows, and we were using people.
But how long can you hold, you know, the people scaring them away individually?
Well, that's your job.
It is not.
It
is not a long-standing solution.
That's,
you know,
that's your job as a.
You're
farmer.
Looking at a quick solution that actually has yielding results, and it is nothing to like pesticides.
There are many options. I believe there are many options.
I think that would be a minor blow of handling this kind of, you know. Epidemic
it's
that
like,
happen.
It's like
we need a heavy blow to deal with this
it's
one.
Like
and if
the
it's
farmers,
pesticides,
it's like the farmers who have gardens near forests and monkeys come to eat their maize. If you go to Chivale National Park, the people there are not killing the monkeys because the monkeys are coming to eat their maize. And they are there, they are many in number. The people there have other methods that you know, exist so that they can coexist with the monkeys. So I think we need to have
I think it would be very wrong for us to, you know, compare locusts with chimps.
No, the locusts, like it or not, are part of the ecosystem.
I think they have more harm to do on, you know, our plantation compared
have
to, you know, the
chimpanzees.
Have
you ever had a monkey in a garden of maize?
Yes, I have.
Do you know what damage it can do?
I
in
have,
one
yes,
day?
I have seen it,
like,
but
this,
I wouldn't compare it to a locust. You're looking at a swarm of flying insects that can lead to, you know, famine within just a period of 1 week, which monkeys cannot do.
Monkeys do.
No, these locusts.
If you have a family of monkeys,
huge tons of food.
My friend, I come from a place where monkeys have attacked our gardens. We Name my friend, you leave a monkey. And it's with children. For
government
just
is
day.
Asking for 7 more billion Ugandan shillings in the fight of locusts. Let's check out this video and get to learn why are they asking for an extra 7 billion Ugandan shillings.
Ensonga y'ebiwuka by'enzige ebyazinze ebitundu by'eggwanga eby'enjawulo ekutte wansi ne waggulu nga mu kiseera kino gavumenti eraze obwetaavu bwa nsimbi obuwumbi 7 okwongera ku 15 eziriwo okulaba nga ebiwuka bino bifufugazibwa. Bw'abadde mu lukuŋŋaana lw'abannamawulire olutuuziddwa ku ssengejero lya gavumenti ery'amawulire mu Kampala, kamyusona y'ebyobulimi Stephen Tebyejuka alambuludde engeri y'obuwumbi 15 ezasoose okuweebwayo gye zasasanyiziddwamu.
Ziri obuwumbi 11 zaagenda. Bulobuna tubadde tuzikozeseza mu kugula eddagala lino n'okugula eddagala erisooka ku lw'enyonyi. Ate enyonyi mujjukire nti enyonyi ze tupangisa nazo za bbeeyi.
Ono agamba nti ekizibu ky'enzige we kyajjidde ng'ate gavumenti ya Uganda eyina ebbanja lya bumbi 11 mu kitongole ekifuuyira enzige ekya Desert Locust Control Organization nga bano batuuteko obuwumbi 11 lw'obuwumbi obune ezasigaddewo tesobola kukola mulimu gwonna.
Ne bakwata miliyoni za dola 3 ne bazisasula organization eri kati ne tusigala nga tubanjibwa entonotono nga miliyoni 2 kati ne bakwata zirendale ezasigaddewo kumpi nga 4 okutuyamba kugula bye mwalabye gye twatise ku nnyonyi n'amaloole ebigenze eri ateze ezime zituyamba kati okukola ku by'ennyonyi esooka.
Obuwumbi 7 obwetaagisa kitegeregese nga bwakutambuza ennyonyi egenda okufuuyira enzige n'okuyambako mu kuddukanya emirimu. Ekyennaku anavuga ennyonyi egenda okufuuyira enzige naye kitegeregese ng'ali mu ggwanga lya Kenya ng'asuubira busuubira okudda kuno nga Tebyejuka bw'alambulula.
Baali bamutwala kuyamba ate mu Kenya ate kata ina kukomawo ajja tuyambe okuvuga ennyonyi ezo.
Ategeeza gavumenti bw'eggyeyo n'agombuuta okulaba ng'erwanyisa kizibu kino nga n'ekibinja ky'abaminisita n'abakungu ab'enjawulo batuuse dda mu bitundu awali enzige.
Bwe twakitegeera mwezi gw'12 ku nnaku 8 January twali wano nga tutegeeza eggwanga kye tulaba ne kye tuluubirira. Ky'ova olaba bw'ebyayingidde bw'ebiti amudaati ku Sande jo kutuuka sawa 7 ennyonyi zaabadde zisitula ebintu okukola ki okubitwala eri kutandika omulimu.
Walabira bino nga waliwo ebitongole ebyenjawulo ebitandise okuddukira gavumenti okuli aba Kingdom Rice nga bawadde ennyonyi 2 ez'ekika kya drone okulaba nga ziyambako mu kufuuyira.
Zikwatagane n'abagenda kubeera gwansi ku ttaka batulabe nga bwe tugwanyisa omulabe.
Tebyejuka era alambudde n'enteekateeka ez'okubangula abantu mu bitundu ebyalumbiddwa enzige.
UPDF bali mu Uganda Police Force, Uganda Wildlife Authority yatuwa abantu 10 bebamu abali mu kutendekebwa tukola tutya bwe ziyingira mu park.
N'abaka ba Paalamenti nabo boogedde ku nzige ezaalumbye ebitundu ebyenjawulo mu ggwanga.
Nze ndowooza nti ministry yaffe ebigwa bitalaze erinamu oluusi weekola obugayaavu.
Tibali bagenze kati kugula ddagala, bagenze kulaba batasobola okubyetegereza ate nga zibadde Kenya nga bamanyi. Nga bwe tuli mu mukago
kakite kyetaagisa tukozese combination all the methods abakulya balye spraying we spray them we kill them all the way
tubiri nga tukozese omukisa guno omanyira wa mukama bw'aba nga atuleetedde enva koza aleese enzige nga oluusi baswazirya kati singa yaleese ebikere bye tutali.
All right, there you have it, of course, for a couple of, you know, people coming out to say that they do need 7 extra billion Ugandan shillings and others coming out to give their views regarding this particular one. But I don't know, I feel like before we release more money for these particular ones, just like, you know, the other time, the minister, I think that was Keith Makanizi, who came up to say that, you know, we need accountability before we release more money.
These guys are just going to eat money, that's the truth.
They are jokers.
No, they're not jokers, by the way. There's going to be some intermediate solution to this, but it's not sustainable.
All right. Let's wait and see how that one tends to work out. Now, moving away from that, still looking into our starter news this particular morning. Coronavirus death toll hits 1,000. Reports coming in on this particular one show that as the death toll from the new coronavirus outbreak exceeds 1,000 people, the top two health officials in central China's Hubei province, the epicenter of the outbreak, have been removed from their posts. Now, Chinese state minister reported, Chinese state media reported Tuesday that Hang Jin, the Communist Party boss of Hubei's Provisional Health Commissioner, and Lui Hizai, the commission's director, have been dismissed. The firings came a day after another 103 deaths were reported in Hubei province, where millions remain under lockdown and people are complaining of food shortages. A total of nearly 43,000 cases across China have been confirmed by the central government. What do you make of this? Just think about it in a Ugandan perspective. You know, after a certain individual has failed to deliver the services that they're supposed to deliver, they just lay them off. Imagine people complaining about bad roads in Kampala, bad roads, potholes, and then, you know, the KCCA acting director, off, next.
Well, the difference between Uganda and those other countries is that Uganda has a different way of doing things. And there are people who can come and malign you and destroy your name and make it look like you haven't done anything. So I don't think it can work in Uganda.
Okay.
I don't advise it should. I think, you know, let's just try to deliver where we're, you know, posted to deliver.
All right.
Other than, you know, if someone doesn't deliver, we fire them. We don't have so many intelligent people.
Okay. And also still talking about coronavirus. Yesterday there was a parliamentary sitting and, you know, some members came through to, you know, talk to the Speaker of Parliament about, you know, affecting people from China. It is a conversation that is happening within the parliamentary walls. But do you see this coming to reality? I mean, there's a message that was read by a member of Parliament. I've forgotten his constituency. But he came up to say that someone from his constituency who's currently in China sent them a message and it was very sad. And these people are double thinking about, you know, affecting these Ugandans from China. What do you make
whether
of that?
They are evicted, whether they are evacuated back to Uganda or not, it's a sad story. What we need to put focus on is, do we have the infrastructure in place? Do we have the things that we need to handle coronavirus if it hits Uganda?
Okay.
And bringing them back to Uganda, like it or not, puts Uganda at risk of having a zero patient, if not at the Entebbe International Airport. So I think that they should be very careful if they decide to evict, to evacuate people back to Uganda. It's a very tricky decision to make.
All right.
Of course, Mike Mukula was being tortured on Twitter when he posted and said that Uganda does not have the capacity to handle coronavirus if it came to Uganda. And people are saying they are bringing back history.
Away from that, more news coming in show that companies have been advised to give more hands-on training to interns. The call was made by Dr. Joshua Mutambi, the Commissioner of the Processing and Marketing at the Trade Ministry, during the launch of the training activities of the agro-processing micro, small and medium enterprises held at Makerere University recently. Now, Mutambi said it was discovered that when students go for internships in certain companies, they are not allowed to touch anything, which claims that they do not have the experience to operate these machines. If you deny them the chance to use your machines, your computer, or work on customers, then how will they get the experience? These are some of the students you are going to ask to apply for your jobs and ask for experiences, Mutambi said. Interesting conversation.
True and, you know, not true.
It's a catch-22 situation.
Yeah, it's always better to first read these things.
Mm.
It's always better if you're coming to intern on television to first read about television. Most of these interns come and they know, okay, they've studied stuff in school, but they don't know how TV works. So it's always better to read. It's just like the people in the graphics department will tell you that it's always better to read a huge volume about designing and starting things and doing things before you actually sit on a computer and do something.
Okay.
So he's right, he's wrong.
So the theory is also important.
It's not the theory, it's actually practical. It's just that you're reading. You understand deeper when you read.
Isn't that what they do at school?
No, they don't. It's not what they do. It's not. They don't have manuals of cameras. They don't have manuals of film and whatnot. What they do, the theoretical bit, not the practical bit. But practical also has its own...
I also think it depends on the university. No offense, but when I was at UCU, we used to have manuals to these things. You know, if we're talking about the camera today, we'd look at the theoretical part and then look at the manual part and the practical part as well. Mm. So I think it also depends on the institution you're in.
Well, that's why I said well, it's right and wrong.
It's right and wrong. Moving away from that into more certain news, a quick one. Now, it's very sad. A 70-year-old has been arrested for defiling his granddaughter. Now, police in Hoima district have arrested a 70-year-old man on allegations of defiling his 5-year-old granddaughter. Police identified the suspect as Keya Kafero, a resident of Buhiriji, local council one in Buhiriji Parish, Bombo sub-county in Hoima district. Kafero reportedly grabbed the child after she had been sent by the mother to collect plates from his house on Monday. After waiting for the child to come in vain, the mother followed her and caught Kafero red-handed defiling the victim. Mr. Julius Hakiza, of course, the Alibantine regional police spokesperson, said. This is very sad. It's very disappointing. But anyway, of course, that is an unfortunate situation happening down in Hoima district. Moving away from that, we want to take a quick look at some shout-outs. Something that you definitely need to know. My shout-out this morning is going into the National Drug Authority. Now, the NDA impound stolen government drugs worth 90 million Ugandan shillings. Now, the National Drug Authority has impounded government drugs worth 90 million shillings from private pharmacies and clinics in Bugisu and Sebei sub-regions in Eastern Region. The drugs were recovered during an operation to crack down on drug outlets that are not complying with license requirements and dealing in a registered medicines. The operations, which took place over the weekend, covered 6 districts of Mbale, Sironko, Bulambuli, Sironko, Kapchora, Skwini, and Namasudwa. Now, among the impounded drugs included unregistered medicines such as Viagra and Postina, not meant for the market in Uganda, Kenya, Malawi, and Zambia. I didn't know. Viagra is not meant for Ugandan market.
It is. It is, but if it's not for sale from government of Uganda and it's caught in a private clinic or private pharmacy, then...
And Postina? Postina used to be on market back in the day. What happened?
For me this morning, I'm shouting out to Robert Wamoga, a.k.a. Wanyonyi. Why? Because the Specialized Utilities, Wildlife and Standards Court has remanded a salesman of a solar company for tampering with solar panels to avoid the supplier from tracking them for full payment. The accused, Robert Wamoga, a.k.a. Wanyonyi, is a 22 and is accused of modifying solar panels of his employer, D-Light Design Company. He appeared in a session presided over by Magistrate Marion Mageni and denied 2 accounts, which include making unauthorized access and modification of computer material. Upon denying the charges, court opted to remand him to Luzira Prison until February 26th, as investigations continue.
All right, there you have it, of course, for the latest shout outs coming in right here on the show, as well as some starting news. Abin today is going to go in for a very short break, but when we do get back, we get straight into the Press Digest.